Hey everyone, welcome to today's video where we're going to be looking at the Halloween word search niche. Now this is a very interesting niche in that it's got high search volume and low competition, which is the perfect recipe for making money with KDP low content books. So if you do like the idea of that, then make sure you watch the whole video. Now, if you've not been here before, my name's Paul Marles, and I do videos on how to make it, keep it, and grow it. And that's your money I'm talking about. If you do like videos like that, then please give it a thumbs up. And also, hit the subscribe button and smash that notification bell to receive notification of when I produce more videos like this. Now, excuse that noise because I live on the river. And a boat, oh, it's a hovercraft that's just going past, so the boat is about to move. Okay, so why are we looking at Halloween now? I mean, it's 3.5 months away. Well, if we go over to Google Trends, we can see that interest on Google is starting to rise from about now. So with any popular niche, or especially a seasonal niche, it's very important to get in there earlier. And here comes a speedboat. Now, with Amazon, when you publish a book, a KDP low content book, often you won't see sales until around about the 3 month mark, if you're going to see sales at all. And that's because it does take a bit of time for books to get into the system, but also for Amazon to assign keyword relevancy to your book, so it will be found in the search results on Amazon. So it's very important to get in there as early as possible. Now, Halloween is one of the big Q4 niches, along with Thanksgiving and the holiday Christmas period. Now, I've recently done a video on the Halloween coloring book niche, which again is a very big popular niche, and I'll leave the link above to that video. So if we go over to Amazon, because now we're going to have a look at the niche and just assess it to see if it meets our criteria, and I'll come to that important criteria in a moment. So normally what I do is go to Amazon and just put in a general search term, and in this case Halloween word search. Now these here are the important things that I look at, and these are the Amazon suggestions. Now this is telling us two things. One is telling us what people are searching for, or Amazon's telling us what people are searching for, but also these are the suggestions that Amazon are giving to customers, and customers will tend to click on these. So straight away we've got ideas of things that are being searched for and words that customers will click. So it gives us that sort of head start, if you like. Now, what I look for is also the Google search numbers per month. Now, I do have a plugin here called Keywords Everywhere, and that gives us the approximate Google search numbers per month, but it doesn't give us for every keyword. And we can see here that the Halloween word search has got 12,100 searches per month, and word search puzzles 170 per month. And it also gives us this nice little graph here, which shows us, as we'd expect, and this is quite astounding, in that July 2019, we've got around about 590 searches per month for Halloween word search, but that goes all the way up to 110,000 per month around the Halloween period. So that's sort of late October. Well, it says November there. And that's even more than the colouring book. So this really does look a very promising niche. So the next thing I do is I will click on our keyword search term and then look at what results are coming up. Now, this is the important figure, or the first important figure I look for, and that's the search results numbers. And this comes out at 365, and that's excellent, because I look for figures of 1,000 or less, because that indicates that the competition is not that high and gives us a good chance of ranking our books on the first page and ideally in the top 10 on the Amazon search pages. In a perfect world, we'd like to get to number one, because the number one slot gets about 40% of the clicks. Doesn't mean it gets 40% of the sales, because normally only 1 in 10 clicks will result in a sale. But you're getting over that initial hurdle. You're getting those clicks, which is what we're after. So yes, in an ideal world, we want to get to that number one position. So that's the first thing. This would fulfill my criteria of 365 results, because that's less than 1,000. So we're now going to look at the books. And the important things I'm looking for here are the bestsellers ranks. And I'm aiming to find three or more books on the first page, ideally in the top 10, with bestsellers ranks of less than 300,000, because that indicates to me that books are selling in this particular niche and for that particular keyword. So if you just have a quick look here, now considering this is July and you wouldn't expect these books to be selling huge amounts, we've still got bestsellers ranks here of 207,000, we've got 1 million, which is a bit high, we've got 260,000, 367,000. So these are in the 1,659,000. Now you might say, okay, well, there's only two books here less than 300,000. But remember, this is July. And from the figures I've just showed you, searches are going to increase by, I think, is it something like 10 times? So we'd expect a lot more sales than what we're seeing here. So this would still be a niche I would go for. And even at 207,000, if we go to our BSR sales calculator, we'll put in 27,000 and we'll see how many they're selling per month in July. So they're selling 24 per month in July at the moment, not a huge amount. But, you know, for those prices, $6.99, $8.99, let's say around about $2.50 in royalties, even in July, you still be making a reasonable amount just off one book. Now, I mentioned about the keywords and how I get this list. So what I normally do is take the lists of words that are given in the suggestions and I'll put those into a spreadsheet. I'll then take each of those individual words, put them into the search bar. If other suggestions come up, those will go into the spreadsheet also. And then I'll look at the search results off Amazon. And also where available, the Google search numbers per month. And those will all go into a spreadsheet. So I have three lists, one of the keyword, one of the Amazon search results, and one of the Google search numbers. And we can see here, I've done this already, and I did this for Halloween in general. And we've got these Halloween word search keywords here. And you can see that all of them have pretty low competition. So this is a really good niche to get into. And I particularly like just the general search term here, Halloween word search, only 462 results, and there's 12,100 Google searches per month. That's at the moment. So that looks really good. There's a lot of searches and very little competition. Just want to add one more thing. When I'm doing my keyword research, I use all, not the books category. I use all because that's the category that most customers are searching in. Now you can see this keyword list here. There's actually 45 keywords in total. That may change slightly as I continue to do research. Now, if you've been to or watched my videos before, you know I've got a Gumroad shop and I sell lists of keywords. These I've put in the Gumroad shop, but I'm actually giving them away for free. So if you're interested in getting into this niche early, go along to Gumroad, I'll leave the link below, and download this list of keywords for free. There are other lists of keywords there for different niches. Some of them you need to pay for. They're quite big keyword lists and things like, you know, popular niches like the colouring book niche. So that's there, go across and get it. So now we're looking at the interiors. So there you have a number of options. Now you're going to need either to pay for word searches, or you're going to need to get some sort of software to create these word search puzzles. Now Fiverr's a popular source where you can outsource getting word searches done for you. I just went to Fiverr, put in word search, and you can see there's all these people here that will create custom word search puzzles for you, obviously for a fee. My favourite place at the moment for graphics, but especially KDP interiors, and not just word search interiors, colouring book interiors, logbook interiors, so many different types of interiors. And they're doing a special offer on the moment for subscriptions. It's normally to get everything, fonts, graphics, print on demand graphics, interiors. I think it's normally around about $29 a month, but they're doing a special at the moment. So let's just have a look, see what that is. Oh yes, it's their Christmas in July special offer, and that's currently reduced from $29 to $18 a month, but it gives you a lot of options. And from there, you can download word search interiors. Now, you've got to consider that if everyone went and downloaded these, you'd have people producing lots of similar interiors. So I'd probably mix and match these, integrating one, say, from something like Creative Fabrica with maybe word search puzzles that you paid for yourself, which would be original. So then you're sort of building up a book of original and puzzles that have already been made. But you can pay for those without having a subscription, or you can have a subscription and get those. So that's a good option, and I'm particularly liking that at the moment. I just clicked on that particular interior, and he or she is offering 50 pages in total. So that's 50 puzzles as a PDF, which should be ready to go. Then the software. Now, a popular one is Puzzle Book Mastery. Again, I'll leave the links to these bits of software below. And with this software, you can create word search puzzles. So you'd have to think up lists of words that you could incorporate into individual puzzles. So you could go to Google or a thesaurus or something and search Halloween related words, get a list of these words, group them together into themes, and then create individual puzzles out of those different themes. So if you've got Puzzle Book Mastery, there's another option here called Puzzle Maker. Again, this is you'll need to pay for this option if you want to download them in PNG format, which you can then just copy and paste into something like PowerPoint or Keynote and create your interior book like that. So as you can see, Halloween word search is a popular and potentially very profitable niche. It's worthwhile getting into, I think. And if you're considering doing this, get in there early. 3.5 months to go. It gives you time to create a book. It gives you time to get that book into Amazon. Okay, so I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, give it a thumbs up. If not, give it a thumbs down. But also make sure you hit the subscribe button and smash that notification bell to receive notification of when I produce more videos like this. And I'm going to be doing some more on the Halloween niche. So until next time, goodbye.